Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
Tameva Sharanam Gacha. Sarvabhavena Bharata Tat Prasadat Param Shantim Sthanam Prapsati Shashvatam. O Son of Bharata, surrender unto Him eternally. By His grace you will attain transcendental peace and supreme and eternal abode. Very easy to understand. There are so many people around us. And among them, the most important person is the Paramatma sitting in the heart. Previous shloka says, Ishvara Sarva Bhuta Nam Hiddesh Arjuna Tishtati. The Lord is situated in the region of the heart. So I have that personality. And I have so many people around me. But it is my misfortune, I do not listen to Him and I listen to everybody else. Even though He is my best well-wisher. There are so many people who may be giving so many directions, but generally they are envious and they give wrong directions. They want to harm you. Correct? They are envious of you. They are jealous of you. This world is full of crazy people, jokers. Ishvara Sarva Bhuta Nam Hiddesh Arjuna Tishtati. The Lord situated in the heart says, Suhrida, I am the best friend. Sometimes parents also give advice, but the advice can be wrong sometimes because they don't know. Just like if some child is sick, mother may give him wrong medicine. Out of goodwill can do harm. Possible, no? Because knowledge is not complete. But Krishna is the best well-wisher because actually He knows what is good for you. And He always wishes well. So you cannot compare parents to Krishna. Krishna is in full knowledge. Parents also wishes they are good, but knowledge is not complete. And then that love is also not complete. You tell your parents, from tomorrow I will not listen to you. Watch your Vasela Rasa will be closed. You won't even know your father. Just say, from tomorrow I will not listen to you. Over. Your relation becomes zero. True? We say to Krishna, I will not listen to you. Krishna is still behind you. Different. And Krishna's well-wish is for the soul. Parents' well-wish is for the body. And I'm not the body. Parents give you the body, but the soul is directly son of Krishna. Therefore, our first relationship is to Krishna. Because I'm Atma, I'm not the body. And I take directions of so many people actually. But the Lord is situated in the heart. And He has come with only one mission. To give you the greatest benediction, take you back to Godhead. He has come to hold your hand and take you back home, back to Godhead, to the kingdom of God, Narayana. That's why the Paramatma is there. But we are not interested. And it is our misfortune that listen to every direction, we take every association, except what Krishna is telling. Okay? So if you want to really make your life successful, you should hear what Krishna is saying. But you say, I want to hear what Paramatma is saying. You cannot hear now. You're not ready. First hear what Krishna Paramatma has given Bhagavad Gita. After that, some more thing is needed. Krishna will tell from the heart. It's already given, no? We gave this argument. Suppose you say, give me 500 rupees. I say, I gave you yesterday 500 rupees. Have you spent? No. First you spend that, then I'll give you more. Correct? Will that be not be an argument? True? The same way you say, I want directions. Already gave you enough directions. Why don't you read and follow that? So you follow Bhagavad Gita. And Krishna is saying here, utterly surrender to the Paramatma. Piriya says, Ishara Sarabhutanam in the Desha Arjuna Sistiti. The Lord is situated in the heart of every living entity. And then he says, no, utterly surrender to him. Actually, Paramatma is not different from Krishna. But Krishna is giving an example. He is instructing Arjuna that we should totally surrender to the Paramatma. The Paramatma position is Mata Smriti Jnanam Apohanam Cha. It gives you memory, it gives you knowledge, and it makes you forget. There's the role of Paramatma sitting in the heart. He's Anumanta and Upadishta. He's overseeing all the activities we are doing. Upadishta and Anumanta is sanctioning. Do this, don't do this. Do this, don't do this. Situation of the Paramatma in the... So what we should be doing? So we should be therefore very careful. The Lord is situated in my heart. How do I serve Him? How do I utterly surrender unto Him? Today we are utterly surrendered to the Maya. And we are running around, wasting our time. Prabhupada used to say, our position is very sound because we accept what Krishna says. We want facts. I was today developing in college about facts. It's a very nice analogy. So the point is this. Most of the people in this world, they are cheated. They have wrong understandings. About spiritual truth. Once you read Bhagavad Gita, you see most of the people are foolish in the society. No idea. So the question then comes, what's happening actually? Why is Krishna allowing to be cheated? Krishna should protect. True? But they are fit to be cheated. What can be done? Cheated and the cheated are combined together. Then we are understanding why they are fit to be cheated. You see, modern day science doesn't talk about Paramatma. Utterly surrender Paramatma in the earth. What they are saying? Where is Paramatma? Who has seen God? They speak all the nonsense. They will say or not? Your friends will at least say. 99% people will say today. They are atheistic. Some are openly atheistic. Others have so many atheistic doubts. So the question comes that how can we proceed on this now? How do you explain? The first thing should be, I should be genuine. I want facts. Make this as your decision first. What is your decision? I want facts. Be determined. Don't budge from this now. You are searching for truth. I want facts. Now, take a book which describes about the truth. Vedas have its own, like Bhagavad Gita is a summary of the Vedic knowledge. It has its own discussion. And you take one book in which it summarizes what science says about the world. Okay? As you open Bhagavad Gita, you'll find something interesting compared to the science books. How would the science will say? Perhaps it might have been, it must have been, that there was an explosion. And it might have led to formation of planets or galaxies. And from that, planets might have been formed. And it must have led to some chemicals. And by accident, by chance, those chemicals would have formed into amino acids. And by further accidents, and by chance, perhaps must have been, or it might have been, the first living cell was formed. So the whole thing goes on. How many times they use might, must have been, perhaps, maybe 100 times? But here in Bhagavad Gita, you see Krishna does not use it once. You'll not find once in Bhagavad Gita Krishna using the word. Krishna is always using the word facts. You'll never see Krishna doing this kind of a thing. You'll never see Krishna using the word. Arjuna, maybe in your heart there is Paramatma. No. Fact. Ishara Sarvabhutanam Hridayesha Arjuna Tishtati. You see the authority? And second thing, every day the science changes. Today they say something. Now they are saying, today is in the headline, Times of India. Headline. Now we found how the life came from water to land. How? Through alga. Because there was the problem. Because inside water you need kidney. No, sorry, inside water you don't need kidney. You don't need lungs. You don't need strong bones to walk. When anything comes from water to land, it suddenly needs a kidney. Because water, there is enough water. Kidney stores water. And you need legs to walk now on, you know, so against the gravity. And then you need lungs to breathe. So how life has come from water to land is a big mystery now. You understand? So they say, no, it has not come from a fish walk. They tried for hundred years trying to figure out what fish came to land. Someone started walking. It failed because changes are too many. It cannot, suddenly water cannot come and start walking. Now they are saying they found a new way. It is not the fish. It is one alga, which actually came from water to land. And then it developed. And they are very fascinated by the new kind of hypothesis. This is today. This is 2017 edition of an idea. 2018, just like a new model of Maruti, a new idea will come out. Another fellow will get. And we have to believe all this. Every day it changes. And not that all the scientists will agree. 90% will say we have objection to this. It's not even coherent. When you go to court of law, you have to actually do something which is known as give your position paper. Suppose there is a dispute on land. You have to give your position paper. How do you say you own this particular piece of land? Correct? So how can you do? It's not easy. It's very difficult. Okay? You understand this point? It's not easy. It's very difficult. So, actually, if you are very sincere and you say, I want facts, you will come to the Vedic knowledge. And Prabhupada says many times this. We do not want hypotheses. We don't want theories. We want facts. Theories are also assumptions. They are propositions. We don't live by theories. We want facts. So if you are adamant on the point, I want facts. Only book you'll pick up is the Bhagavad Gita. Facts. How the creation happened. This is how the creation happened. Full stop. No perhaps, might be, must have been, nothing like that. Second thing, the scientists can also not give you. They will say, billions of years ago, life came in this way, and billions of years later, life will come in this way. Today, you just believe. Billions of years ago, life formed from chemicals. We can't prove it today. And millions of years later, we will perhaps prove it. That also perhaps. Post-dated check. Take it, but today, simply believe me. It's not scientific. It's not reasonable. These are not facts. If you give a proposition, you should prove it. But then they will say, can you prove? Yes. The path is also given. So many people have practiced a path and they have seen the truth. Gyanina tattva darshinaha. They have seen the truth. And they're giving you a way. If you follow the way, you can also see the truth. Isn't it more safe and secure? Anyway, you have to believe somebody. Prabhupada said you have to believe somebody. You can't see what the scientists are telling anyway. Are you seeing electron microscope? We have no time for all that. Correct? They are speaking something and they are hypothesizing something. Anyway, they have not seen. But anyway, you believe what they say. Might be true. Here there are people saying, yes, I am seeing. Is there any scientist who says, I am seeing how from chunk explosion happened and black. Is any scientist says I saw? Nobody has seen. Any scientist has seen life came from chemicals? Nobody has seen. But you go to the Vedic side, have you seen? Yes. Have you seen God? Yes. There are people who say I saw God. That's all the Shastra is. What is Shastra? Is the Anubhava. Is the experience of the realized souls. So you have people who are vouching. Yes, I seen. Correct? It's not an assumption. It's a fact. So it is so safe. Isn't it safe? It is so safe. But the Vedas are telling it's so safe. It is so safe. So we have to invest faith somewhere. But intelligent man will invest faith in the Vedic literature. And then it gives you a path. If you accept that path, you will advance in spiritual life. And you can see the symptoms. Right from day one, when you start practicing spiritual life, your heart and mind becomes purified. We discussed that as six symptoms of taking to spiritual life. We had a program, the house program. What are the six? The moment you take to a genuine spiritual path, your heart becomes purified from all anxieties. You feel so peaceful. We discussed so many symptoms that day. You develop all wonderful qualities of a gentleman. You find so much spiritual happiness. So much spiritual happiness that you're not even interested in liberation from this world now. You don't want moksha. Then, fifth. It's very rare to get spiritual happiness. Very rare. Eating, sleeping, mating, these pleasures what science is offering and enhancing. That is there anyway. Animals are doing that. Correct? What is scientists doing today? Wasting their time. They're trying to satisfy the senses of animal-like human beings. That's all. Working hard, day and night, to create comfort for these animals in the human form. That's all they are being used for. So much intelligence, finally, unfortunately, the scientists, all the intelligence is used for this base, satisfy the base desires of animal form human beings. But, and what are the last thing? If you take to spiritual life, and as Krishna recommends in Bhagavad Gita, we take to devotion service to Krishna, even Krishna gets attracted to you. Krishna is very attractive. You go to Tirupati, you see lakhs of people are waiting to get darshan of Krishna. They get darshan for a short few minutes. Still they are waiting to see. Krishna is so attractive. Correct? Something is attracting them. They get darshan for a few seconds and again, one day they have to stand to take darshan of the Lord for a few seconds and again they come after a few months. What do you say? Is it attractive or not? Some reason is attractive. The same way, even though Krishna is so attractive, the whole world wants to see him, wants to have his darshan for so many reasons. Krishna becomes attracted towards his devotee. He is moved, he is enchanted, he is captured by the love of his devotees. That is the six beautiful characteristics of the devotion service. Take care. So they're so glorious. And what is all this? Paras, might have been, must have been, jokers. It's for intellectually weak people. Those people who are intellectually strong and they say, I want facts. They will never, never, never agree with the scientists of today. They'll reject that knowledge altogether. Therefore, you see, Srila Prabhupada always rejected the knowledge of the scientists. Why? He never gave any value. Somebody was talking to Prabhupada. Prabhupada, they say like this. Prabhupada said, why you say they say? I also have they say. If you have authorities, I also have authorities. Which are better authorities? You can judge. Most of the scientists even don't even have good character. But here the Vedic authority, the character is so sublime. They are worshipable even for their pure character. True? Vedicas. Where is the comparison? And it's for us to decide where the truth is. When truth is somewhere, something should be visible, no? Suppose somebody has a truth. I want the six things to be visible. What is the six things to be visible? You should have total peace. You should have total peace. Number two, he should have all wonderful qualities. You say, I have the truth with me. I know the truth. Okay, I look for this. I don't know what is inside. I have to believe anyway somebody. You are saying, I have the truth. You are saying, you have the truth. But I have to see the six things should be visible. Number one, we should have total peace. Number two, we should have all wonderful qualities. Number three, we should have unlimited happiness. Number four, you're not even interested in so-called liberation. And number five, it's very rare to get the truth. What you got, correct? And number six, even Krishna is attracted to you. God is attracted to you. But where the scientists will stand in this picture? No qualities,
No peace of mind. No happiness. You don't even know what is moksha. And then fifth. Very rare. Nothing rare about them. Nothing rare. Muktanam avisiddhanam narayana parayanaha sudullabam prashatmatma koti shubhi mahamuniyam crores of the munis. There is somebody who gets Krishna in his heart. So, rare. So we don't have a competition. Don't think we have a competition. No competition only. Okay, we, Prabhupada says, we are on a very, very firm footing. We are on a very, very firm footing. Nobody can shake us. We can shake the whole world. Nobody can confuse us with, they can bring one more. Don't know, do tell me now. If you hear now Elga from that, you laugh at it. In fact, what Prabhupada says for such thing, goat with what it does not eat, and a madman what it does not speak. Just like goat eats anything, madman speaks anything. So we should not get boggled by their daily new funny theories. We have a firm footing from the message of Bhagavad Gita, and solidly we should stay, take steps and advance in Krishna consciousness. Srila Prabhupada ki, Bhagavad Gita ki.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama.
Hare Krishna.